I welcome you all on behalf of the Honorable HOD. Extends hearty welcome to our Honorable Chairperson, Honorable Justice Shri Randa Menon, Justice Yushi Srivastav, Justice Sharanda Shukla, Justice Verma, Lieutenant General PM Harris, PVSM, AVSM, SM, VSM, Honorable Judges of the Mumbai High Court, Justice Mahesh Swanath, Justice G.S. Kulkarni, Justice Bharat Desh Pandey, the Principal Registrar, Dr. Dushyant, Dr. Dinesh Shetty, Registrar, Mumbai High Court, Flag Officer Commanding Goa Area, Rear Admiral Vikram Menon, VSM, ADG Litigation Army Headquarters, Major General Javed Iqbal, President Bar Association Goa, Advocate Kolo Pereira, Service Officers and all Officers of the Court and friends from media. I'm highly grateful to the Honorable Chairperson to have guided us on his thoughtful step to set up the circuit bench in Goa for the welfare of servicemen and ex-servicemen of the state. Today is the glorious day that this bench is being inaugurated by the Honorable Chairperson, Justice Sri Narendra Menon. A word about the Honorable Chief Guest. Sir has an illustrious career. He graduated from Jabalpur and was standing counsel for central government from 1991. To the elevation to the bench in the year 2002. I'll keep it in brief, although he has a long list. He served initially as an additional judge of the Madhya Pradesh High Court in 2002, graduated to permanent judge in 2003. He headed the Gwalior bench of Madhya Pradesh High Court till March 2008 and thereafter posted at Principal Bench, Jabalpur. He has coveted appointments. In brief, to include that he was acting Chief Justice of MP High Court from 2016-2017, Chief Justice of Patna High Court from 2017-18, Chief Justice of Delhi High Court 2018-19, and he took over as Chairman Armed Forces Tribunal in the year November 2019. I now invite following dignitaries to the dais, please. Advocate Kolo Pereira, President Bar Association. May I request you to please come on dais. Please. I request Honorable HOD, Vice Admiral A.R. Karve, PVSM, SM, AVSM, to please come on dais. May I now request the Chief Guest and the Honorable Chairperson, Justice Randa Menon, please come on dais, please. May I now request the Honorable Chairperson to kindly give his inaugural speech.
Present. It's a great occasion for the Armed Forces Tribunal. We are inaugurating a new circuit bench of our tribunal in Goa today, and this is a step in furtherance to the mandate of the judiciary, justice at doorstep. We in the Armed Forces Tribunal have our principal bench in New Delhi with 10 benches spread from Srinagar to Cochin and from Jaipur to Guwahati. We have circuit benches. Kochi has a circuit bench at Bangalore, Chennai has a circuit bench at Hyderabad, Lucknow has a circuit bench at Nainital, and Srinagar has a circuit bench at Jammu, and now we have the Mumbai regional bench, a circuit bench at Goa. Our tribunal, friends, is different. We cater to the requirement of a very special category of persons who fight for protecting us every day. They dedicate their life to the nation, and when they come to us with small grievances pertaining to their disability, pension, pay fixation, promotion, it needs immediate attention, and any delay in redressal of their grievance sends a wrong message to the men in uniform. They have dedicated their life to us, and if we cannot give them justice timely, no use having such a tribunal. And therefore, the Goa bench was conceived, and it was Admiral Kerve who said that, sir, there are some cases of Goa. We need a bench in Goa for two reasons. One, to cater to the requirement of the litigants of Goa, and secondly, to spread awareness about the right available to the people in uniform. What I found after joining the bench was that many of the men in uniform are not aware about the existence of such a tribunal. And Justice U.C. Srivastava is here, he heads the Lucknow bench, and he conceived the idea of having legal awareness camp in areas concentrated by retired persons from the forces. We had a legal awareness camp with the Uttar Pradesh State Legal Service Authority in Nainital. It was done in the areas there, and we found that after the awareness camp was held, people started coming to us, particularly retired persons with their grievance of pay fixation, pensions and certain disability matters. I was discussing the issue with Justice Mahesh a few minutes back, and when he suggested that the members of the bar should also be made aware of the military law, the difference in the military law and the normal law on which we practice day in and day out, and there should be an awareness camp for the members of the bar also, and he requested me that the Armed Forces Tribunal should come forward to do it, and I have willingly accepted it because I feel it's also necessary. I have been in the field of litigation for last 40 years, 21 years as a lawyer and 21st year in the administration of justice, and when I took over the post of chairperson of the Armed Forces Tribunal and started dealing with the cases of the Armed Forces Tribunal, I found that the first principles of law which I used to apply as a lawyer and as a judge could not be ipso facto applied to the disputes pertaining to the men in uniform. It needed a different approach. And one of the most peculiar feature of this tribunal is that we don't hear cases in a single bench. All cases are heard by a division bench consisting of a member judicial, who is a retired High Court judge, and a member of the administrative member, who is a retired member of the force, Army, Navy or Air Force, above the rank of a Major General. And when the combination of this bench, dear friends, is really wonderful. The legal aspect, the law part, is taken care of the judicial member, and the practical aspect of implementing the law in a place, in a institution or an organization which has various security concerns of national importance is taken care of my learned members from the administration, who help us in taking decisions which is required to be taken, more so after taking the importance of Article 33 of the Constitution. As a practicing lawyer and as a judge, it was very rare that we wanted or we were aware of the implications of Article 33 of the Constitution. It is only after I joined this tribunal, I went through the history of Article 33 and I found that it's a officer of the Judge Advocate General Branch who himself introduced the provisions of Article 33, and he was one of the judges of the Guwahati High Court, a man in uniform who became a judge in the Guwahati High Court and who conceived the idea of having Article 33 into the Constitution. So these are some of the technical aspects, and as Justice Mahesh requested me, it's a good idea to have an interactive session, an awareness session with the members of the bar and others to tell them what is the peculiar requirement of military law. Today, my brother judges and the lawyer friends have to attend to their day's work, except for thanking the High Court from the core of our heart for having permitted the circuit bench to function from the High Court campus I feel it's a great honor to the men in uniform that the High Court has come forward to extend this helping hand. I'm hopeful that with the bench regularly functioning in Goa under the leadership of Justice Shailesh Shukla and Admiral Karve, the people in Goa will be benefited and will be able to dispense justice to the needy who are waiting for their grievances to be redressed. Thank you very much for the patient listening and the honor given to me. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Honorable Justice Rajendra Menon, Chairperson of the Armed Forces Tribunal at Delhi. Our Honorable Judges of the Bombay High Court at Goa, Honorable Members of the Armed Forces Tribunal from various benches who are present here today, Flag Officer Commanding Goa Area, the JAG Army who has come down from Delhi, all the various members of the Bar, and those who are present here from the Army and the Navy, other friends, very good morning to you. Armed Forces Tribunal, Mumbai Bench, Regional Bench, I extend a very hearty welcome to the Chairperson who has kindly consented to come down as chief guest for this function. I also extend a very hearty welcome to all of you who have taken time off from a busy schedule to be present here. Especially, I am very thankful to the Honorable Judges of the Bombay High Court at Goa, who will very soon be conducting their courts in a short while from now, but still have kindly and graciously consented to be present for this occasion. A circuit bench at Goa has always been in the planning, and finally we have managed to set up the bench over here, and in this regard I would like to express my gratitude and thanks to the Chairperson of the Armed Forces Tribunal who has supported us in full measure to by giving various approvals and permissions to set up this circuit bench. At the same time, I will be failing in my duty if I do not acknowledge the exceptional support provided by the Bombay High Court, who readily and willingly and without any hitch agreed to give us the use of their facilities over here when we approached them in Bombay for setting up the circuit bench. I am also very grateful to the Flag Officer Commanding Goa Area as well as the JAG Army who have also supported us in so many ways for setting up this circuit bench. The Chairperson has highlighted the importance of a circuit bench for litigants both serving and retired. It is a forum available to them to redress the various grievances which could not be addressed by the service. And this tribunal has been set up in 2008, and thereafter it has come a long way. As Chairperson already mentioned, there are so many benches all over the country, with some of them having their associated circuit benches like the one over here. In this session, approximately 80 cases have been listed. Some of them are from Goa, some of them are from Mumbai. But in the coming days and months and years, we expect that with the spread or the with the awareness of a tribunal of this nature, there are more people will become aware of its presence and come forward to redress their grievances in this forum, which has been provided for by the government by way of the Armed Forces Tribunal Act 2007. In the Mumbai bench, we are very happy that now there is a permanent member who has been recently appointed. In fact, nearly 23 members have been recently appointed by the government to fill the various vacancies of the Armed Forces Tribunal. This happened this month, and now the tribunal will be working at full strength hereinafter. And we hope that this will help the litigants in getting their grievances redressed much faster and in a shorter time frame. COVID was a big challenge for everybody, including the tribunals, including our bench. But despite that, hitch and hurdle, we continued to function by adopting various innovative means, including through virtual conferencing, and we were able to still somehow dispose of many cases. I assure everybody here that the circuit bench over here of Mumbai in Goa will continue to work towards the noble cause of providing justice and redressal of grievances to those who are affected, and we will leave no stone unturned to achieve this noble cause and aim. Finally, I once again would like to thank each and every one of you for being present over here, and also all those who have come forward to help us set up the first ever circuit bench in Goa. Thank you, Jai Hind.
EVSM, AVSM for the invaluable advice, and thanks to everyone present here and also to those who have not mentioned.